We opened the Skidmore lab a year ago with the primary purpose of supporting our faculty, staff, and students, especially teaching product development and the process of that, which is very different from what you find in the kitchen people know at home. As the lab has evolved and we've got it operating at full speed, we now can start looking to open it up to people in Indiana, entrepreneurs or entrepreneur wannabes, if you will, that have an idea for a product and really don't know where to go with it. So opening up the product development lab and expertise that we have here with Erik Kurdelak and others allows them to come in and start that process.
In the Skidmore Laboratory, we represent a wide variety of technologies, technologies that can be used to bring that product from the home scale, commercial kitchen scale, to the actual production environment. So when we think about different things like perhaps the vacuum system here that we can use for sous vide processing, not everybody's going to have the opportunity to use one of these on a daily basis, but they can come in and we can collaborate with them. They can use this one. They can explore that technology and compare it to other methods of cookery. When you think about chilling, scrape surface chillers, we have blast freezers, we have ice immersion, we have all kinds of different devices for pulling that heat energy out of products. Beyond that, of course, we also have a lot of mechanisms for bringing heat energy into products. So forced air ovens, open flame, flat tops, char grills, gas ovens, things like that. We'll have induction tops throughout. We also have frying, so frying under pressure is different than atmospheric frying, and we can look at those nuances. Beyond that, we'll have steam chambers, steam over roasting, we'll have microwave with a lot of different power available in that application. And this is really an important space for the folks who are trying to identify how do they bring that product to market, how do they enter that part of the Indiana economy. So when we think about moving from the stock pot of the sauce that's been in the family for 100 years and it's just perfect, now how do we scale that so everybody can enjoy it? You know, we have to stop thinking about recipe and start thinking about formulation. We have to stop thinking about cookery so much and start thinking about food processing. There's a lot of hard science that goes into it, and we can be that guiding hand to help folks along. So that's the way that we're really opening up the Skidmore space for those collaborations.